What's up? How y'all doing? We gonna have a good time now. This the pimp daddy portion of the show. I'm glad to be performing in California, because I was in Yuma, Arizona last week. Yuma, that's a Spanish word. That means Jesus Christ is fucking hot. It was so hot, I had to spray a can of Pam in my front seat just to slide my fat ass out the car. I jumped in the pool and felt like a damn tea bag. And this guy found out I'm from Florida. He gonna come up to me analyzing the heat. I thought if it's hot as hot, heat is heat. He tell me, oh, you from Florida. Now this here is Arizona. This is a different kind of heat. It's a dry heat. I say, dry heat? You kiss my wet ass. And in LA, what is this, four seasons in one day? Raining and sunshining at the same damn time. All this crazy weather got me so sick. Last night I had to get me a bottle of NyQuil. You know NyQuil, don't you? That's the nighttime sniffling, sneezing, coughing, achy head. So you can catch a buzz medicine? I should have knew something was wrong when it came with its own shot glass. And this hot weather in LA makes people do some crazy stuff. Doesn't it seem like the hotter it gets, the crazier people act around here? I read something in the paper about this man they call a B.O. Bandit. That's what they call him, the Body Odor Bandit. He robbed 10 banks. They said that this motherfucker smells so bad that when he walks into the bank, people get down on the floor and give him their money. Now you really gotta smell like shit to rob a bank with no gun. And this has started a trend, because there are some people on the street that smell so bad, you would pay them just to get them the hell away from you. Guy came up to me the other day. Would you give me 50 cents if I washed your windows? I said, man, I will give you $20 if you would just wash your ass. And when you drive in your car, you see these people with these signs, we will work for food. This is tough times. I will work for food my damn self. Shit, I need to get me a sign. Have you ever met anybody that really wants to work for food? That's just a scam so you can stop and give out your money. So I got my own scam. I pick them up. Take them to my house, work the shit out of them, and give them a peanut butter sandwich. They be looking at me like I'm crazy. Could we at least have some jelly? Some jelly? You gonna have to paint the whole house if you want some jelly. And you can tell the ones that I picked up because their signs are different. We work for food, buffets only. We gotta do something about this homeless problem, because we're running out of shopping carts. I guess that's bad. I shouldn't be talking about the homeless, but they ain't in here. It ain't like you gonna go outside, find one, and say, you should have heard what that guy said inside of there. One thing you don't see a lot of, you don't see a lot of homosexual homeless people. I guess that means if you can suck a good dick, somebody gonna let you stay with them. But I helped the homeless. I was homeless myself. I was down and out. I was so broke, I didn't even have a pair of shoes. I was feeling sorry for myself till I met a man with no feet. And I thought to myself, I bet he got some shoes at home he don't need. My name's William Rock the House Lewis. Thank you.